everybody. Welcome to Your Capital What's Up. I'm Chuck Wiger, your area state senator. Thank you for watching. Today we're going to talk about a great project that's sponsored by the North St. Paul, Maplewood, Oakdale Rotary, and our guest is Randy Greeley. Welcome to our show, Randy.
Thank you, Senator.
And it's the all about patriotism and the American flag. And tell us about the project, and then we'll get more about your background. But what is the project about? And we've seen the flags that people display, but it's because of the Rotary and others.
Yes, that's correct. About 3.5 years ago, a couple members of our club noticed a steep decline in showing the flag, especially on the flag holidays.
Yes,
which had kind of peaked after the 9/11 incident and stuff, and so. They were trying to figure a way that possibly could bring some of that spirit back, specifically on the flag holidays.
Yes.
So one of our members, Fran Ivory, actually was a member of the Rotary Club in Davenport, Iowa years ago, and he remembered a flag program that the Optimist Club had down there. So he called one of his friends, and he drove up to one of our meetings and sat around afterwards and talked to a few of us about how the program worked. We thought it was a great idea and thought we'd adopt it. So basically what it involves is a subscriber enrolls in the program.
It's called the American Spirit program?
The American Spirit, yes.
Okay.
And makes a subscription of $48 a year to our Rotary Foundation, our club's foundation.
Yes.
And then a volunteer comes out on the 6 summer flag holidays, starting with Labor Day and running through Veterans Day.
Right. 6 of them throughout
six
that
of
period.
Them, right. And places a flag, which is on a 10-foot pole, mm-hmm. On the boulevard in front of their home. Mm-hmm. So the idea is because a lot of our customers might have a flag on their home and stuff, but what we're trying to do is decorate the street or the neighborhood. So our primary areas, of course, that we're working in is North St. Paul, Maplewood, and Oakdale, but we have customers in Bayport and Monomedi area and Grant. And so it's really taken off. We've got about 150 subscribers now, and we're kind of reaching the limit of our membership to place the flags. And so we're looking for a partner group, a Boy Scout troop or something that might like to earn dollars by partnering with us in placing the flags, or 4-H club or somebody like that.
Okay.
So basically what the volunteer does is they have a route, might have 6 to 18 flags on their route. Mm-hmm. They go out on the flag holiday and place.
That be the night before?
No.
Or on the day of, so yeah,
on the
six flag holidays.
Right.
And then
right.
On the day for
the
flag,
holiday.
The volunteers will go out to the subscribers.
Right. And place the flag by 8 a.m. that morning, anytime they want, prior to 8 a.m., after sunrise and prior to 8 a.m.
Yes.
Flag will be up. And then volunteer returns in the evening about sunset and takes the flag down. So. Customer doesn't have anything to do. We buy all the materials and the flags, and we make all the poles and assemble the poles, mm-hmm. and attach the flags, and then run the program for them. So that's
great.
Pretty much how it works.
Okay. And how's the response been in the different communities?
Very good. We found that if we can get 2 or 3 customers on the same street, that we get a little growth spurt
yes.
as we were able to move down the street. We teamed up with the Tartan Deca Club
yes.
last spring, and they went out in the Oakdale area and partnered with some Rotarians and some DECA students, and we did a door knocking campaign, and picked up 15 subscribers in one neighborhood in
Wonderful.
Oakdale. Well, actually, and expanded some additional subscribers in a neighborhood where we already had about 15 flags, so it worked out very well. And then we gave them a commission for each sale that they helped us get.
That's a win-win, and working with the young people at the club and, you know, bridging that, the importance of why we display the flag. And
that's right.
So, right. Well, wonderful, and you're looking for expansion. The public has said, yes, we like this, and you're potentially going to be partnering with the Boy Scouts and other potential groups as you explore that.
Right, right. That's the idea.
Good. Well, I commend the Rotary and for your service, and I'd like to for you to share a little bit more about yourself, if you could, Randy. And I know you're living in nearby Grant, but were you raised in the area?
Yes. Well, actually, I was born in Milwaukee, but my mother moved back to her hometown, St. Paul, when I was about three. So mm-hmm. We lived a little bit on the east side, and then my parents bought a home in Newport. So I was primarily raised there through high school. Yeah. Went in the Navy when I was 17. Got out
Good
when
for you.
I was 21. And
what was your specialty then?
I was fire control technician. Mm-hmm. So that was the person who worked on the computer systems on the ship that coordinated radar systems with the gun mounts to lock on targets, and we tracked the target, and the gun mounts automatically followed where we let them on our computer systems.
Okay.
So.
And then that journey that eventually got you to Grant.
Yes.
Some highlights.
I got married and had a daughter. We lived on the east side for a while. We bought some property in Grant, and about 5 years later, saved enough money to build a home out there, and that was in 1979. So we've lived in that home since then.
Okay. And your career after the Navy?
Well, I went to St. Paul Voltech School, now
yes.
St. Paul College.
Yes.
Did 2 years there as a design technician course of mechanical drafting. So I got a first job on the east side of St. Paul in a conveyor company, working in the engineering department designing conveyors. Then left there for a company in North St. Paul called Standard Conveyor. Worked in their engineering department for about 7 years, and then moved over into their inside sales department, and then into their outside sales department.
Wonderful.
And then the company went out of business in 1980 in their 75th year.
Yes.
And so
my father worked at Standard Conveyor many years
he did.
Ago. Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Well, many area people did, so it was a great
yeah,
company.
Yeah, it was about 250 employees. It was a national distribution conveyor company, one
yes.
of the big three in its day, conveyor company nationwide, and a great place to work. But there was some rough financial times in those days.
Yes.
And, didn't quite survive that. So being in sales, when they made the announcement they were going to close the company, they had a special announcement for they had about 3 months of materials that they could work through on the job, so it gave them a little more time. But being in sales, we had a special meeting saying, well, we'll see you at the end of the week because we're not going to sell anything anymore. Temporarily bought out by another conveyor company out of Michigan. They tried to put it back together for about
yes.
2 years, so luckily I was only out of work for a couple of days, because when I was in sales, I got called back.
Yeah.
And that lasted about 2 years, but it was a great 2 years because it gave me a lot more experience in outside sales, because after they decided to close it down and actually auction it off, so it,
yes.
that was when it came to permanent end. 2 weeks later, one of the other salesmen and I formed our own company and started our own business in North St. Paul. And basically, it was a conveyor sales force for manufacturers outside of the area that did not have representation in
yes.
this area.
And that flourished.
And we did that for about 35 years
yes.
until I retired. and we ebbed at about five employees.
Yes.
And then as everybody retired, I was the last one to go and just close the business down. We were all about the same age, so.
Well, I commend your entrepreneurial spirit and success, and it, you know, have the roots and you know, your patriotism, having served our country. And you, I've seen you at other events in the community, for example, at the Veterans Park in North St. Paul, which is, you know, recognizing the service of so many of the area veterans.
That just went in, formally, right. And that's how I got involved in the North St. Paul Maplewood Oakdale Rotary Club, was when we started the business. Went up to a local bank to open an account. One of the club had just formed about 10 months before, and one of the charter members was the bank. I think it was like called Northwest back then. It was just a trailer in the Maplewood Mall parking
yes,
lot at the time.
It was.
And he invited me to the meeting, and I had just switched from being an employee to now being a business person.
So yes.
I went to the meeting. And I guess I never left.
Yeah, those connections that can really open a door. And so Rotary provided that opportunity.
What really, I guess what surprised me was that the number of small business people, men and women, professional people, managers of larger businesses in the area, busy, busy people.
Yes.
Gathering every Friday morning to see what else they could do financially and with their time to help people in the community and outside the community into the larger world, because it's an international organization now. So, and it just, I was so impressed. I ended up staying with the organization, so.
Yes, and you certainly are making a great contribution in the American Spirit Project, which we talked about earlier.
Yes.
Other projects that you've been involved in with Rotary?
Well, I did a 10-year stint with a mentoring program at Tartan High School.
Great.
With the seniors there, and basically worked a mentorship program. We teamed up with a staff member and a Rotarian volunteer.
Yes.
And the school provided students that they felt might benefit from our program. And we met at the school after hours, provided speakers for the first half, and then for the second half of the meeting, broke into our individual mentoring groups so we could deal with issues that the students were having, or questions they might have about what happens after senior in high school.
It's quite a commitment, 10 years. How did it go?
It went real well. At the end of the year, we had a banquet for the students, gave out scholarship money that we would we raised during the year.
Yes.
And based on the scholarships were handed out based on the most improvement in their GPA. So we took their GPA as it stood at the end of their 11th year and compared it with the GPA they had earned during the program in their senior year, and those that were most improved got the scholarships. It was five or six scholarships a year we handed out that they could take to any school they wanted to.
Wonderful. Do you know of any that may have had a real good success story then following their post-secondary experience?
Yeah, it's been about 3 years since I've been in the program, but I would say that about 50% of our students took their scholarship money up to Century College.
Yes.
So we drove a lot of business up their way. Others went on to University of Wisconsin, Minnesota, and some private schools, and helped them probably buy books.
Yes.
And we have gotten letters back from some of the students, which were quite surprisingly positive to me of how much the program had meant to them, not so much the scholarship money, but the time that was spent with them. Because
yes,
for the cost of a college education, a $1,200 scholarship doesn't necessarily play a giant amount financially of help, but Most of the comments we got back were the time spent with the staff, school staff, and the Rotary mentors, so that was pretty positive.
It's going to be a great feeling to have an impact in someone's life.
Yes, it was. And also, we do community service. We have a program where we hand out a dictionary to all the third graders in the entire school district once a year.
Okay.
And it's a real great program, and the school district helps us set it up. And we provide the books, and then the Rotarians go into the class, and we hand them out, talk a little bit about Rotary and the importance of learning, the importance of reading, basically,
yes.
And understanding what you're reading. The dictionary is the place to turn when you don't know the word.
Do you find you read the dictionary yet? There's always a new word. We're always learning.
Yeah, we give the third graders seem to love it, and we've done it enough years now that when we go into the classroom, there's a lot of the children expecting us because their older brothers and sisters
yes.
have them, and they're still carrying around, and the younger kids are talking about it. So, and it's maybe surprising in this digital age that they're interested in a dictionary book,
yes.
but it's a personal thing that
yes.
they can carry around, put their name in, and so it's really fun to go in those classes. And you can
okay.
go on our website look at some of the pictures of the kids in the classroom. And we
would have the local participation on your website?
Yes,
okay.
all of our programs are listed there, so people that
Good.
Are involved in our flag program can see how the money's spent.
Great.
Our organization, 100% of the operation of the club is funded by dues.
Yes.
So 100% of the profits of any fundraiser we hold goes out to our programs.
Okay.
So, and then we work with we have a close relationship with North St. Paul High. All of our exchange students, international exchange students, go there.
Yes.
So they've been a big support on that program with us. Rotary International has the largest international student exchange in the world. Exchanges from one country to another, and the U.S. is a giant participator in that program.
Yes.
And they come here in their junior or senior year and spend 8 to 10 months here. So
mm-hmm.
it's a long program. And then they spend their time in the homes of 2, 3, or 4 volunteer families that take them in. So we try to give them a broad perspective of the American lifestyle. And so,
wonderful.
Because there's so much volunteer work on the end, it's a very affordable exchange program compared to a lot of the other programs out there.
Great. Any other programs regarding the American spirit or just encouraging the importance of the democracy and what the flag stands for?
Well, we
freedom.
We did run a program, I think it was in North High, for a couple of years on business ethics, going and send business people into the classroom talking about looking for ethical, we want more people to go into business, and we're looking for people that do it in an ethical way.
Yes.
And so talked a lot about that. We did that program for several years, and we team up with the Tartan Uprising program,
mm-hmm.
and we go to some of their fundraising events, or not fundraising events necessarily, but some of their charitable
yes.
events they do, and they come and work with us on some of ours, like food shelf and things like that. So.
So there's a lot of activities, and it could keep you busy all the time, I guess,
yes,
if you
yeah.
want.
There's a lot going on, and we have several areas of service, and so you can, from community, international, and members of the clubs can switch from year to year what area they want to work in so it never gets boring.
And it looks like the Rotary, when they say they want to do it, they do it. They get it done, and if there's this idea in Iowa that's working, like on the American Spirit, you bring up the idea and they say, are you in? And you're in, and then you do it.
That's right. We got about 150 customers. We got supplies to in-house now to do another 150 flag placements, so we're looking to expand that program.
I want to congratulate and thank you for your service, Randy, and we're almost out of time. Would you like to share any concluding comments about the program or Rotary in general?
Well, you can find out about the program by going to the American Spirit website, which is theamericanspirit.org.
Okay, theamericanspirit.org.
Right, and the club is the North St. Paul Maplewood Oakdale Rotary Club, so you can go to our website by going to nstpmorotary.org.
Great. Okay. Well,
and I appreciate the time, and it was nice sitting with you here and discussing this. I really appreciate it, Senator.
Well, back at you, Randy. Thank you so much for your service, for the Rotary service. You make our community a better place to live, our planet a better place, and it's got to be a very rewarding feeling for you, and we are so appreciative.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Randy. Thank you to the Rotary for their great service. And viewers, if you have questions, please contact Randy or anyone at the Rotary. I know they're always looking for additional volunteers as well. If you have a question of me, comment, please give me a call. My cell phone, 651-770-0283. For your Capital What's Up, I'm Chuck Wiger. Thank you very much for watching.